Today, we're going to be talking about the USDC situation. So what happened? Well, in the early Saturday morning hours on March 11th, the Silicon Valley Bank or SVB failure caused the USDC to depeg from $1. The price dipped to almost 88 cents before recovering at the time of this video. And the reason for the depeg is that Circle, the company issuing USDC, has $3.3 billion in reserves tied up at SVB. And this is money backing the value of USDC. And if it was to be lost as part of SVB's failure, it would mean a financial hit for Circle. So what happened to Silicon Valley Bank? Well, last Friday, Silicon Valley Bank, or SVB, was shut down by the California Department of Financial Protection and Innovation as the bank collapsed due to a bank run amid concerns over its financial health. And this was the second largest bank failure in the U.S. since Washington Mutual in 2008. The state-chartered commercial bank has a lot of crypto entities as clients, making its failure particularly relevant for the crypto industry. The Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, or FDIC, has taken receivership of the bank. According to an FDIC press release, all insured depositors will have access to their insured deposits. And the past weekend saw the second most valuable stablecoin, USDC, depeg as a result of banks' failure, including Silvergate and Silicon Valley Bank. And it didn't take much time for the panic to spread as Signature Bank was also closed by U.S. financial regulators on Sunday. And there is one major link connecting these banks, which is exposure to the crypto industry. So let's go over a brief history of Signature Bank. Signature Bank is a full-service New York commercial bank, and it was known for its convenient service and deep connection with the real estate and legal sectors. With 40 private client offices across 5 U.S. states, the banking institution had 9 national business lines, including venture banking, mortgage servicing, and commercial real estate. By the end of 2022, the bank had accumulated a total of $110.4 billion in assets and collected deposits amounting to $88.6 billion. In the late 2010s, it grew both geographically and in terms of services it provided, most notably with its decision to embrace cryptocurrency businesses, which accounted for 30% of its deposits as early as 2021. Hailed as one of the top crypto-friendly banks, Signature Bank had established a 24/7 network for its crypto clients, which led to significant growth in its crypto deposit portfolio. And according to CNBC, the total number of deposits went up as high as $16.5 billion from crypto investors. On March 12th of 2023, the New York State Department of Financial Services shut down the bank following 2 days of turmoil after Silicon Valley Bank imploded, making it one of the most significant financial collapses in U.S. history. So why was Signature Bank seized? Well, to put it shortly, Signature Bank faced the repercussions of Silicon Valley Bank's collapse and subsequent seizure by regulators on Friday last week. And as news of Silicon Valley Bank's woes spread like wildfire, contagion hit Signature Bank's customers. And according to the New York Times, most Signature customers had more than the $250,000 limit insured by the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, or FDIC, and consequently felt vulnerable about potential losses in case of a similar incident. And a flurry of withdrawals over $10 billion began to happen. And despite this, outflows actually slowed down by Sunday morning. However, in a shocking turn of events, a statement was released by the Department of the Treasury, which announced the resolution of Signature Bank in a move to protect the U.S. economy by strengthening public confidence in our banking system. So let's talk about the impact on crypto. Well, both Signature Bank and Silvergate Bank had launched Signature's Signet Network and Silvergate's Exchange Network, SEN, to improve the transactions of digital assets between crypto platforms and their banks. Coinbase and Circle and other crypto companies incorporated Signet and SEN to assist institutional customers in transferring, managing, and settling accounts. However, after the collapse of these banks in quick succession, analysts have cited it as a huge step back for cryptocurrency infrastructure, likely resulting in reduced liquidity within the U.S. And some in the crypto space believe the seizure was part of a wider move by regulators to shut down crypto in the U.S. So how bad is this for USDC? Well, it's not great by any means, but there is a good reason to believe that it's nowhere near as bad as UST, meaning USDC is not going to go to zero. As Ignace explains, Circle has a fraction of its reserve stuck in SVB, but that is only about 8%, and it doesn't mean that the money is gone. Most of its reserves are actually short-term treasury bills, and the fraction held at SVB will likely be recoverable to a large degree. But currently, it looks like Circle is actually just taking a slight financial hit that is easily recoverable from the profits it makes by operating the stablecoin. But then why did USDC depeg so much? Well, it's likely because the market has PTSD from the USD collapse, and because Coinbase and Binance stopped USDC conversions and contributed to an illiquid market. Also, the Curve 3 pool got drained very quickly. And on Monday, insured depositors got paid by Silicon Valley Bank, and the fallout for now is still to be determined. But on the bright side, USDC has fully repegged following Circle CEO Jeremy Allier's statement that 100% of the deposits from SVB are secure and also will be available to clients. And as the story develops, CoinMarketCap Alexandra will provide more updates, so make sure to check out the description below for the latest information.